It was every mother's worst nightmare. All Kelsie Lewis could do was look on in horror as her little baby convulsed in pain. She had no idea what was causing it until she discovered a deadly insect crawling on his body. Lewis and her family live in Buckeye, Arizona, and in May 2017, they were no doubt getting ready to enjoy their first full summer with 10-month-old Jericho. Unfortunately, that's when catastrophe struck. It had been just an ordinary day when little Jericho began acting out of character. He was crying uncontrollably and withering around in his crib. And yet there was no obvious sign at all as to what was causing the baby's distress. Lewis's mom tried desperately to discover what was wrong, inspecting her grandson closely. And that's when she saw it. There, on the little one's arm, was a scorpion. Understandably, the mother grew extremely concerned. The worried grandma made the wise decision to ring for an ambulance. In the meantime, however, Jericho's state began to spiral, and it must have been terrifying to watch. His little boy was convulsing, and his eyes and tongue were flitting around in his head. Furthermore, Jericho's tiny little cheeks had started burning bright red. His breathing grew even more labored, and soon he was throwing up too. It was a hugely distressing experience for the baby's family. However, in the heat of the moment, Jericho's grandmother began filming the scene on her smartphone. Perhaps she believed it would come in handy once they got to the hospital. Whatever her reasons, the resulting footage proved very hard to watch indeed. Eventually, emergency services arrived and took Jericho to Phoenix Children's Hospital. There, medical staff confirmed a bark scorpion had stung the baby twice, once on his thigh and once on his wrist. Bark scorpions are one of the most common scorpions in Arizona. They are, however, also the most venomous. And not only are their stings painful, in some cases, they can actually prove deadly to small infants. Bark scorpion bites thousands of people each and every year in Arizona. However, only 2 deaths have been recorded in the state since 1968, and so Jericho's chances of survival looked good. Nevertheless, doctors said they were very fortunate the baby's grandmother had spotted the insect on his limb. Scorpion bites leave minute marks that can be notoriously hard to spot, even for specialists, and so his grandma's close observation had helped towards a quick diagnosis. To combat the scorpion venom, little Jericho needed 2 vials of antidote. But after that, all his family could do was pray. There's really nothing you could do to console them at that point. It's just waiting, Lewis told CBS5. Thankfully though, Jericho made a full recovery within just a few days. However, his mom was keen to warn other parents of the impact scorpion bites can have on little children. It's like a whole body spasm because it attacks their neurological system, she told KCTV. And so Lewis took to her Facebook page to spread the word. Alongside a lengthy status, she uploaded the harrowing footage of Jericho's symptoms. These videos may be hard to watch, even for me, but I felt like they could be informative, she explained. Lewis went on to explain that the most severe symptoms didn't emerge until 1 hour after the sting. She explained that, at first, Jericho had suffered uncontrollable secretions from the nose and the mouth. He was also crying uncontrollably. I can't imagine how this would have turned out had the scorpion not been visible, she added. I didn't know that this was the type of reaction that can happen from a sting, so I would have been clueless to what was going on. Knowing what happened and seeing the changes made it a very easy decision to call 911 immediately, Lewis continued. It could be the difference between life and death. I'm hoping this could help if someone else is in this situation, since I and many of my friends and family live in the desert. Lewis finished her post with an update on her little son. I wanted to thank everyone again for the prayers for Jericho. He is doing so great, completely back to normal. However, she admitted the family are all on edge still. If you encounter a scorpion sting, ice and antiseptamine should ease the swelling and cool the itch. However, victims should also contact their local poison control center. They will decide if further medical treatment is required. There are precautions people could take to avoid being bitten in the first place too. Shoes should be worn, especially at night. And if you're working outside, put on a pair of gloves. When it comes to scorpion stings then, it seems vigilance is key. Thank you.